देवाञ्छित लाभाय कर्म किं तन्न कथ्यते किं दंपतिमिति ब्रूयाम उदाहो दंपति इति आई थॉट वी कुड जस्ट हैव द टेक्स्ट एंड रीड इट सो वी वर लुकिंग एट पतिक देवा राइट दे हैड ऑल गॉन टू सत्यलोकम एंड देयर दे सॉ द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द No, there are gradations even when you have done your Punya Karma. There is a huge gradation and difference between how the others behave and how the Devas are behaving. So, Pravishta Matrascha Te Parihrita Rajas Tamo Gandha Anubandhataya Parinata Sattvaika Sareshu Tatratya Vastushu Mahicharaha Iva Mahendra Bogeshu Adrishtacharam Vishesham Alakshayantaha Visishmire. They were very surprised with the different objects that they were looking at. Just like how people who come from the Bhulokam, how they act when they look at the different things in the Amaralokam, Amaravati. In the same way, these people were also looking at the objects that were there in Brahmaloka, and they were very surprised by what was there. Okay. Now the next paragraph. Next paragraph is how, you know, the people who were there, the Brahmarshis or the Rishis who were all there, they are there because of the position that they have been given by Maheshwara to be in that Satyalokam for such and such a designated time. And these people are there. So how do they look upon the Devas who have arrived? So the Devas were looking at those people who were looking at them in turn. So that is the description, and they were also ridiculing them by saying, you know, poor Indra, look at how he is, poor Agni, look at how he is. So they were, it was as if they were all ridiculing the Devas who were arriving to see Sanat Kumara. Apicha, Prikriya?
Apicha, Punaha Atma Vijnana Nirasta Avaranataya, Nisima Vikasat Akritrima Jyotisham. அதிகாரமலக்ஷபணாய கேவலம் அனுத்தரம் யோக ஐஸ்வர்யம் அனுபவதாம் அத்ர பவதாம் சனக சனந்தன சனத்குமாராதி மகாயோகினாம்
So it goes and ends with the drisham avalokayantaha. Liadrisham avalokayantaha devaha. If you go to the next paragraph, then you will find it all goes in ityadini parihasa vachamsi bhikshadanam jyaya iti menire. That is where it is going to end. Okay, the entire set, even though there are sentences in between, you have to include the shloka that also comes and then end with the gadhyam there. So yeah, let's look at slowly one by one. Drisham avalokayantaha. They were looking at the drishti of the others. Who were the others? Tesham drishtim avalokayantaha suraha evam menire evam manyante. So kesham drishtim avalokayantaha. Those who are present in that satyalokam. Those people who are present in satyalokam, how are they? Nissima vikasat akritrima jyotisham. Akritrima jyotish, jyotis is the prakasham that they have, the tejas that they have is akritrima. It is not something which is kritrimam is chayarke, adhaadu man-made. Kritrimam is man-made, akritrimam is that is which is swabhava, which is naturally present in them. The effulgence or the prakasham that is there in them is very natural. Akritrima jyotis, which is vikasat, which is just shining forth without any limit. Nissima, there is no limit to the prakasham that comes out, emanates from them. Why do they have such a prakasham? It is because atma vijnana nirasta avaranataya. Apicha punaha, that is just a way of saying, you know, further the people who are there. So how, why is there prakasham like this? Atma vijnana nirasta avaranataya. So avaranam is that which covers everything that is there. So if you think of the world, Brahma Satyam Jagan Mithya is the word Brahmo Jivo Brahmaiva Naparaha. That is the tattvam that we say in Vedanta, right? Jagat Mithya. This entire world is Mithya or it is false. And Brahma Eva Satyam. Now, why is it that we see all this? Because there is something called Ajnanam, and that Ajnanam has two qualities. It has something called Avarana Shakti and Vikshepa Shakti. Take the Jivan, for example. We don't need to go into the external things. Now, we know that the Shariram is Mithya, and it is only the Atma Swarupam that is there in us. It is the truth. Now, this Atma Swarupa is Swayam Prakasha, that is, it is Prakasha Swarupam always, and it can, just like how Agni does not need an external thing to show us that the Agni is present. If some object is there in the dark, we take a torch and show that this object is there. So, in order to view an object, we need that torch. But in order to see where that light is, do we need another light? We don't. The same way, that is called Swayam Prakashatvam. To understand Ahamasmi iti jnane, ko api anyaha maam vaktum, I don't need another person. Avashyakata na vartate. I don't need someone to come and tell me, you exist. I exist. Iliya, adhudan the Swayam Prakashatvam. Correct? So that is the Atma Vijnana. Whereas that Atma Vijnana, nobody... We don't understand that the Atma is Swayam Prakasha because the Ajnana is covering it and saying that, I am in pain when it is just your hand that is paining. You say, I am suffering, I am thirsty, I am hungry, but it is only your Shariram that is hungry. Why? Because the Ajnana covers the Atma Swarupa. And then it shows that the Atma is actually this body and everything. So you feel that this body is Atma. So that is the Avarana Shakti and the Vikshepa Shakti that exists for Ajnana. Now what is happening here for these people, their Avarana Shakti is completely gone. Nirastha Avaranataya Atma Vijnanena Brahmatma Jnanena avidyayaha ajnanasya avarana shaktihi nirasta. So that ajnanam is completely removed because of the atma vijnanam, and hence they are prakasha swarupam akritrima jyotihi vikasate. It is in contrast, why he explains, gives such a beautiful adjective for them is, in contrast you have to look at Kalividambaram. There he will say, he will ridicule the Kritrima Jyotihi, those who have as if they behave as if they have that Jyotis, they know everything. He says, Sada Japa Pato Haste Madhye Madhye Akshimilanam Sarvam Brahmeti Vadascha Sadhyaha Pratyaya Hetavaha. If you have to believe, make someone believe, even though you're a fake sannyasi, you want to make someone believe that you are great, then what do you have to do? You have to have that japa in your hand, japamala in your hand. Madhye madhye akshimilanam. You should not keep your eyes open or keep your eyes closed always. You have to open your eyes and look at everybody as if you're gracing everybody with your drishti. Madhye madhye akshimilanam. And then sarvam brahmeti vadaha. Sarvam brahmamayam. Jagan Mithya Satyam, Brahma Satyam Jagan Mithya. Keep on talking, making such statements like this. These are the three things that will make people believe that you are the greatest soul on earth. That's his way of ridiculing the people who, the fake sannyasis that you have, the middlemen that you have today. So in contrast, he can also describe people who are in that Brahma Jnana. Atma Vijnana Nirastha Avaranataya. They have removed the effects of Ajnana by their Atma Vijnana. And hence, they are shining forth without any boundary. Nisima Vikasate Akritrima Jyotisha. By Brahma Jnana, which is Akritrima. Next, Adhikaram Adhikara Mala Kshapanaya Kevalam Anuttaram yoga aishwaryam anubhavatam. Anubhavatam. They are experiencing that yoga and aishwarya. What is this yoga? Yoga is ashtanga yogam. Yama, niyama, asana, pranayama, pratyahara, dharana, dhyana, samadhi. These are the eight parts of yoga. So they practice that yoga. Anubhavatam. They are enjoying. They are not just practicing because they have practiced the yoga and they have come to this level. Here, they are not abhyasatam. They are anubhavatam. Now they want to just do, you know, just for the, this is, snatasya, you know, a person who is very dirty and he wants to take a bath. He takes a bath in the Ganga. He doesn't go there to remove that papam. He goes there to just enjoy the waters of Ganga. That is how they are doing here. That is how they are doing yogam here. So they enjoy the practices of Yama, Niyama and everything because they like that path. In the same way, Aishwaryam Anubhavatam. Aishwaryam is also the Ashtama Siddhi. This is not just the wealth or any money and luxuries of the world. The Aishwaryam that he talks about here is the Ashtama Siddhi, which we also spoke before, Anima, Garima, Laghima and all that. So those Aishwaryam also, they are practicing. Now here, Anuttaram. Anuttaram yoga aishwaryam anubhavatam. This yoga and aishwarya is the ultimate goal. It does not have uttaram yatra na vidyate tate anuttaram. Where there is no other next step. Like Krishnat param kimapi tattvam aham na jane. I do not know any other tattvam beyond Krishna. That way this is the anuttaram yoga aishwaryam. There is no tattvam, there is no goal beyond this yoga and aishwarya. So they keep on practicing this again and again because they like it. That is why anubhavatam. Now why do they do that? Adhikaramala kshapanaya. They have been given this position in satyalokam. Even that position is called mala or papa. In order to remove kshapanaya, in order to remove that papam associated with even this adhikaram, that is, this is after all deham. They have that deham that is given in the satyalokam. There is something called videha mukti, where you do not have any deham at all and you become that atmaswarupam. So until you are placed in the satyalokam, you are still enjoying the shariram that is given by that, that is limited by that satyalokam. They want to be in a state where they are not limited even by that satyaloka sharira. So adhikara malakshapanaya, or Ishvara would have told them, you know, just be here till this time and such a date or such and such a karyam is done. Even that they want to remove and they want to be one with that atmaswarupa. So adhikaramala kshapanaya kevalam anuttaram yogeshwaryam anubhavatam. Simply, you know, in Kumarasambhavam, kenapi kamena tapaschachara. Why should Shiva perform tapas? He was sitting there and doing tapas. Kenapi kamena. Because he wanted to experience and enjoy that samadhi avastha, he was doing it. He did not have any goal in mind. He was ever in that Brahmajnana. Why should he perform that tapas? There is no necessity for him. But he did. Why? Anirvachaniya Swarupa. He wanted to experience an anubhava. He wanted to have that anubhava constantly of that Brahmajnana, and that's why he was doing tapas. Next. Atra Bhavatam. Who are those people who were in this state of Brahmajnana, Atra Bhavatam, those who are residing in that Satyaloka, Sanaka, Sanandana, Sanat Kumaradi, Mahayoginam, Drisham Avalokayantaha. So those yogis who are Sanaka, etc., those who were staying there, they were looking at the drishti of the Sanaka and other rishis. How were their drishti? He is explaining the drishti of those people. Of the yogis.
Mukeshu iva vagminam, murkeshu iva buddhimatam, andheshu iva chakshushmatam, adhaneshu eva maheshwaranam kiteshu eva sarisrupanam sarisrupeshu eva chatushpadam chatushpatsu eva manavanam manaveshu eva mahibhritam mahibhritsu eva marutam marutsu eva marutvatah marutvati api patantim avagnyam avagnya mukulitam drisham avalokayanta.
Their drishti was like how vagminam mukeshu eva. If a person who is eloquent, orators, how will they look at people who are not able to speak? Mukaha. That is how these yogis were looking at the devas. So vagminam mukeshu eva, like orators on people who cannot speak. Buddhimatam murkheshu eva, like intelligent people who look upon fools. Chakshushmatam, those who have eyes, how do they look upon people with andheshu, those who do not have eyes. So with pity, I really pity the fact that, they are not able to achieve this status. That's how these people were looking at, the Mahayogis were looking at the devas. How the adaneshu maheshwaranam, maheshwaranam drishtihi katham adaneshu patati tatha mahayoginam drishtihi etesham. Okay, so the way rich people looked upon the poor, kiteshu, this is a mala, I think it's a mala upama alankaraha, right? Sarisrupanam kiteshu eva, sarisrupeshu chatushpadam. It comes in the form of a shrinkhala, that is like a chain, as how, sarisrupanam drishtihi kiteshu eva, just like the snakes look upon the worms, and how the four-legged look upon the snakes, chatushpadam sarisripeshu eva, manavanam drishtihi chatushpadeshu, like how the men look at the four-legged animals, and how kings look at normal men, mahibhritam manaveshu eva, just like how marutam mahibhritsu eva, the winds are flowing everywhere, and they have a freedom and a higher status than the kings. So marutam mahi britsu eva, just like the winds look upon the kings. And then even the position of wind is not as high as marutvan. Marutvan is that who maruta asya marutaha asya santi iti marutvan is Indra. So just like how Indra looks upon the winds, in the same way, avagnya marutvati api, even on Indra, these people are looking with avagnya. Avagnya is a sort of a neglect or contempt. They are looking at Indra, even on Indra, etesham drisham avagnya mukulitam patantim drisham avalokayantaha. Their eyes were falling even on Indra with the, they were closed in contempt. Avagnya mukulitam drisham patantim drisham, the eye which was falling on them, the sight which was falling on them, avalokayantaha, the devas were in turn looking upon the drishti of the Mahayogi. Okay? Puriyadilla? Idu mala upama adane madhe. Enna andha iva vara madri.
ಶೃಣ್ವಂತಶ್ಚ ತೇಷಾಮೇವ ಹಂತ ವರಾಕ ಶತಮನ್ಯುರ್ ನಾಮ ಅಯಮೇವ ಪರಿತೋಷ್ಯ ಯಹ ಶತೇನ ಅಶ್ವಮೇಧೈಹಿ ಅಪಿ ಭಗವಂತಂ ಇಂದುಶೇಖರಂ ಪ್ರಾರ್ಥಯಾಮಾಸ ದಾನವಾಮಿಷಂ Swarajyam.
Everything is going to go and connect here. Ityadini parihasa vachamsi. So what are all the parihasa vachamsi? They were shrunvantaha. Ityadini parihasa vachamsi, tesham parihasa vachamsi shrunvantaha. So they were listening to such ridicule talks. Parihasa vachamsi, tesham, those mahayoginam. Mahayoginam parihasa vachamsi shrunvantaha devaha tatra. Now what were the parihasa vak? Hanta varakaha shatamanyuhu nama aya. This shatamanyu, The adjective itself he puts is very beautiful. Shata Manyo, he performs 100 yagas to get this Indra Padavi. Varakaha Saha. Papa, you know, so sad this Indra has to perform hundreds of Ashwamedha Yaga and he has come here for what? Ayameva Shata Shatena Ashwamedhaihi Shatena Ashwamedhanam Shatena Yaha Indushekaram Paritoshya. He made Shiva very happy. Indushek Bhagavantam Indushekaram made very Shiva Paritoshya. He made him happy with 100 of Ashwamedha Yaga. Shatena Ashwamedhaihi Api, even though they were 100 Ashwamedha Yagas, Shatam cannot be declined in Shataihi, right? It can only be Shatam. It will be only in singular. So, even though Ashwamedha Yaga is in Bahuvachanam, you have to use Shatam as only singular. So, Shatena Ashwamedhaihi Api Yaha Shatamanyuhu Ayam Indushekaram Paritoshya Santoshayitva Danava Amisham Swarajyam Prarthayamasa. After, you know, pleasing Shiva, you can ask for whatever you want in this world. You can ask for moksha from him. Right? And what did they end up asking? Danava Amisham. They asked for this. It is like a meat in the hands of Asura today. This Swarajyam. Swarajyam is Swargarajyam. They asked for this position of, or this kingdom of Swarga, which is enjoyed by the Asura today. The Asuras, it is like a enjoyment. Amisham is literal meaning is mamsa, whereas the Lakshyartha is bhogya vastu. Danavanam yatu bhogya vastu tathavidam swarga rajyam prarthayamasa. Who? Indra. Next.
Pashyata pashyata kubera mimam pashupasha vimochina pashupata vratena samaradhya paramatmanam sakha asi mama iti anugrihitaha api yaha pishachahaiva dhanapalatam vavre.
Kubera, what did he do? He took up the pashupata vratam, which is pashupata vratam itself is a very great form of vrata, where you lingam pranam samadhaya prane lingam shambhavam. So this is the quotation that is given in the vyakhyanam for pashupata vratam. If you look at this, lingam linge pranam samadhaya, you first make your pranan as aikyam with that lingam, Shiva's form, right? So you merge your pranan with the lingam, and then prane lingam cha shambhavam. And into your pranan also, you have to enforce that lingam into your pranan, which is a mutual sayujyam is what he is asking. You have to completely immerse yourself in that preeti. And then sharire manah krutva kinchit chintayet hridi. Sharire manah krut. Everything, you just make it into one and you think about Shiva in your mind. That is the whole idea of that bhakti, where the image of Shiva, it becomes one with your mind, shariram and manas and hridayam and everything. Okay, that is a type of pashupata vratam, and that vratam he followed. What is this vratam for? Why do you follow this vratam? This entire sayujyam, salokam, samipyam and all that leads to something called pashu pasha vimochi. It liberates you from the pasha or the bondage that binds all the pashu. Pashu is jiva. In the Shaivagama, in the Shaiva Siddhanta, jiva is referred to as pashu. Shiva is called Pashupati. It is not because he is the pati of all the pashu, which is cows. No, it is not that cow that is mentioned here. Pashu is jiva. Jiva, because he is Viveka Rahita, he does not have any Viveka, and hence he gets bound by the bondages that are there in this Janma and this Samsara. Right? So, Pashu Pasha, the bondage that binds him to the Samsaram, it removes him from that bondage. Tadrisham Pashupata Vratam அனுசிருத்திய கம் சமாராத்திய பரமம் ஆத்மானம் சிவம் சமாராத்திய கஹா குபேரா. வாட் இஸ் தி குபேரா டூ? ஹீ கேன் ஆக்சுவலி பி, யூ நோ, சிவா அட் தி எண்ட் ஹி சேஸ் சகா அசி மம இதி அனுகிரகீதா அபி. சிவா ஹேஸ் ஆக்சுவலி கிவன் அன் அனுக்கிரகம் டு குபேரா, சேயிங் யூ ஆர் மை சகா, அண்ட் தட் இஸ் வை ஹி ஸ்டேஸ் இன் கைலாச, விச் இஸ் ஆக்சுவலி பார்ட் ஆஃப் குபேரஸ் புரி, அலகாபுரி. அலகாபுரி இஸ் பாஹ்ய உத்யானம். இஃப் யூ ரீட் மேக சந்தேஷம் யூல் நோ, பாஹ்யோத்யான சிரஸ் ஸ்தித ஹர சிரஸ் சந்திரிகா தௌதஹரம்யா. சிவா இன் கைலாச இஸ் ஆக்சுவலி லைக் த கார்டன் ஃபார் அலகாபுரி, அண்ட் அலகாபுரி இஸ் குபேரஸ் சிட்டி. Yaksha actually tells Megha to go to this Alakapuri, which is in the outskirts of that Alakapuri. Shiva is performing his tapas, and on the head of that Shiva you have the Bahyodhyana Stita Harashiras Chandrika, the Chandra which is there on the Shiva's head. The rays that come out of Chandra, it will just make that Alakapuri entirely white. Dhauta Harmya, the cities of Alakapuri has been made, rendered white because of the Chandra that is there on the head of Shiva. So Shiva has accepted Kubera as his friend. Tvam mama sakha asi iti yaha Kubera anugrihitaha saha kim babre. What is the vara that he asked from Shiva after performing that Pashupata Vratam? Pishacha eva dhanapalatam vavre. Like how Pishacha dhana samrakshanartham, you know, there are, if you think of the treasures that are, you know, buried underneath, underground, you are never supposed to take it out because some Pishacha is protecting that pot of wealth that is kept underneath the ground. All these underground treasures that are there, if you come across anything, you are supposed to give it to the king, or some you have to surrender it to the government. You are not supposed to take it because it is not your wealth. So people believe that it is being guarded by all these pishacha. So pishacha eva, here Kubera's position is to protect all the wealth of the devas. So dhanapalaha saha pishacha eva dhanapalatam vavre. As if he is like a pishacha, he has taken up the position of protecting the wealth of the devas. Sure. Pashyata, pashyata, look at this Kubera, who has actually asked for the position of protecting the wealth like a pishacha, even though he performed the Pashupata Vratam. Kim bahuna?
கிம் பகுனா ஆத்மபூதஹ அபி அயம் அஷ்டமூர்த்தேஹ பகவதஹ வைஷ்வானரஹ விபலீகிருத்ய விவேகம் உபாஸ்ய சிரதரம் காலம் உமாரமணம் அபி ஆசாத்ய
ஹவ்யவாஹனதாம்
ஹவ்யவாஹதாம் அன்னஹரஹ அஸ்மி தேவானாம் இதி அபிமன்யதே கிருதகிருத்யம் ஆத்மானம்.
In Agni, he is supposed to be one of the eight forms of Shiva. Atma Bhutaha, Shivasya Ashtamurti. If you in Shakuntalam, the first shloka he says is Ya Srishti Srashturadhyaya Vahati Vidihutam Yahavihi. Ya Murtihi, Shivasya Ya Murtihi, Pratyakshabhiv Prapannas Tanubhiravatuvas Tabir Ashtabhirishaha. Ishasya Ashta Tanavaha Vartante. There are six, eight forms of Shiva with which we pray to him. Kalidasa calls upon all of those to protect us. So each of those forms are Prithivi, Ap, Tejo, Vayu, Akasha. These five Panchabhuta, Surya, Chandrama, Surya and Chandrama. Adhikapura, Yajamana, one who performs the Yaga. He is also, that is the Jiva Swarupam. So Shiva has eight different forms in this world. So the second form that he describes, Ya Srishtihi Srashtuhu Adya Srishtihi, is Jalam. And then the next one is Agni. Vahati Vidihutam Ya Havihi Yacha Hotri. So Ya Murtihi Vidihutam Vidhina Hutam Havihi Ya Vahati Murtihi Sa Api Shivasya Ekatanuhu. Which is Agni, the one which takes all the havis to the different devas. So he has become one of Shiva's murti, Atma Bhutaha Api Ayam. Even though he is treated as one of the Agni being one of the eight forms of Shiva, he has lost his discriminating power. What to do? Vivekam Viparigritya. Vivekaha na karyagarya vivekaha. What you should do and what you should not do. After getting one of the forms of Shiva, how can he think, become so arrogant and talk of himself as Havyavahana? I take the, you know, I am the provider of food for the devas. It is such a lowly position that he wants, and he is thinking arrogantly about himself. So Chirataram, for a long time, Kalam, Kalaha is Mahakalaha is Shiva. Umaramanam, one who is also the consort of Parvati, Upasya, after doing Upasana for Shiva for such a long time and becoming one of the Ashtamurtehe Bhagavataha Atmabhutaha Api Vivekam Vipalikritya. He has lost that discriminating power. Havyavahatam Asadhya. He attained the position of Havyavahana, one who bears or one who takes the Havyam, the oblation, the sacrificial oblation that is given into the fire. He takes that position. Annaharaha Asmi Devanam. Devanam, for the Devas, I am the Annaharaha. I take the food for the Devas. Iti Abhimanyate. Atmanam Kritakrityam Abhimanyate. He thinks he has achieved that which has to be achieved. Kritakrityaha. Kritam Yaha Karoti. He has achieved whatever that has to be achieved. He thinks so high of himself. Abhimanyate. Abhimanyate Garvena Sancharati. Hanta.
Hanta. Chiradiman Deva Pashun Drakshma.
Adrakshma.
Adrakshma.
Adrakshma na idu Kartari Lunga. After a long time, we are looking at these Devas. Not just Devas, Deva Pashun. They are equal to Pashu. Devaha Pashavaha Iva is one thing. Or Devaha Eva Pashavaha Jivaha. We are looking at these Jivarashika. You know, as a group, we are looking at them after a long time. Poor Devas.
Kimna nigrinhanti manaha, kimna bhajante janaha shivam sharanam, abhisandhi veda matran mokshopayena badhyante.
Both readings are right. Moksha apayena, moksha upayena, both are right here. Moksha rupa apayaha or mokshaha eva upayaha. Both will fit here. So they are wondering, ityadini parihasa vachamsi. They are feeling actually not parihasam, they are feeling more pity, dainya vachamsi. They are looking at them with pity here. Kimna grinna nigrinnanti manaha, janaha shivam sharanam kimna bhajante. Why don't they control their minds? Manaha kimartham na nigrinnanti. Why are they not controlling their minds? Kim janaha sharanam shivam na bhajante. Why don't they pray or worship to Shiva, who is the eka sharana? Sharanam is rakshakaha, or he is the only person who sharanyaha in the, for he is the shelter or the refuge for everybody. Why don't they worship Shiva? And why are they constantly being bound? Badhyante kimartham cha mo badhyante abhisandhi bheda matrat moksha apayena badhyante. So they are being bound by moksha apaya. Okay, moksha apayam means moksha rahityena badhyante. They are being bound by the absence of moksha, which is they are not, even if they are praising Shiva and even if they are doing upasana to Shiva, they are not asking for moksha. Instead, they are only asking for something that will bind them again and again into this samsara or this janma and purajanma. Abhisandhi veda matrat. Abhisandhi veda na, adhavadhu, andha, the abhisandhi veda is the pala. Abhisandhi is palam. they are having an attachment only towards the goal, fruit of whatever their action is. So if their action naturally leads to moksha, they are not going to that, but they are only looking at what they want to achieve. So they are so much focused on the phalan that they are not looking at moksha at all. So abhisandhi veda matrat, because of their interest, here the panchami is hetu panchami. So because they are constantly engaged in, you know, a greed towards the fruit that they want, that is the goal, they are very goal oriented. Moksha upayena badyante, mokshasya upayena badyante. So moksha, in order to achieve moksha, you are traveling through a path of yama, niyama, etc., etc. Now when you are doing that, you also get aishwaryam, right? What are the aishwaryam? Which is the ashtama siddhi, which is the moksha upayam. It should be the goal towards moksha, but they are the means. Upayam is the means. It should be the means towards moksha, which should be the goal, but they are not looking at the goal, but they are only looking at the means, which they think is the phalan. So abhisandhi veda matrat, they are looking at the means itself as the goal, and they are only focused on that as the goal, and they are being bound by the janma, punar janma, etc. You get? Puriyudha?
Actually, enakku munnadi oru doubt irundhathu, ippa theendhathu.
Okay. So that is moksha upaya. Whereas moksha apaya means abhisandhi veda matrat, because they are constantly looking at all these small, small goals that they have in life, because of that factor, they are being bound by moksha apaya or moksha abhava. They are in constantly in a state where there is no moksha, which is janma. Puriyudha? You can explain it in two different ways. See, moksha upaya will also fit, moksha apaya will also fit. Mokshasya yeye upayaha vartante, that is your yoga aishwaryam, you have to take it here. So moksha upayena te badyante, if you are a person, one is for a person who is in this world constantly, who is looking at the bhogas that are there in this world. Let us take that level first. So the normal people who are in this world, they do not control their mind and they do not worship Shiva. Hence what happens? They are only looking at the small, small goals that are there in their life. Abhisandhim bheda matrat, because they are constantly kama vashat, because they are looking at the bhogas that are vishayas that are there in this world. So what happens to them? They are bound by moksha apaya. Because they don't have any mumukshutvam, they do not have the interest in moksha, because moksha abhavena te asmin samsare badhyante, or asmin samsarena badhyante, moksha apayena badhyante, moksha abhavena samsare badhyante. They are being bound to this world because they do not have any interest towards moksha. Next level is a person who is traveling in the path of yama, niyama, pratyahara, etc., etc. They also do not control their mind, because you see that Indra wanted the Swarajya Padavi, Kubera wanted Dhanapala Padavi, and Agni wanted the Havyavahana Padavi. So they do not control their mind, and they do not constantly, they are not in the worship of Shiva. Hence what happens? Abhisandhi matrat. They are only looking at the phalan that they get from all this, which is of a higher cadre, maybe. But still, that is only moksha upayam. So they are constantly bound by the different ashtama siddhis that they get from the in the process. So they are only dwelling in the process and they are not attaining the goal, which is the moksha. Puriyada? Two different levels. You know, the shloka seems so simple. Kinna nigrindanti manaha, kinna bhajante janaha shivam sharanam, abhisandhi veda matrat, mokshopayena, mokshapayena badhyante. Ityadini parihasa vachamsi shrunvantaha. It goes to the beginning. Okay? Next.
इत्यादीनि परिहास वचांसि पश्यन्तः
तरतम भावम्
तरतम भावम् ऐश्वर्येषु परित्यजन्तः स्वर्गादिराज्यदुर्मदम् अपत्रपा नष्टदृष्टयः स्वयम् आधिपत्यात् अस्मदीयात् अत्र भिक्षाटनं ज्यायः इति मेनिरे.
So they thought more than Swarga, it is better to even be a beggar here in this Satyalokam. So swadhi swayam adipatyat asmadiyat adipatyat bhikshatanam varam iti menire. So ityadi parihasa vachamsi shrunvantaha, hearing all these ridicule words that these people were all talking. And then taratama aishwaryeshu taratama bhavam pashyantaha, they were looking at the comparative and superlative, the differences in the wealth that was there between, that is the anima, etc. Whatever they were experiencing, they also had some aishwarya. They had luxuries, and at the same time, they also had a lot of these powers, right? Even the devas had powers. That is why they are in that position. But when they looked at the aishwarya that was there in the Saktilokam, they understood the tara tama bhava. Tara is comparative and tama is superlative bhavam. The differences that existed in the aishwaryam, in the wealth between the one that is in the Satyalokam and one that they were having. They looked at that difference. Next, swarga adirajya durmadam parityajantaha. They left the arrogance that they had in ruling the swarga. Swarga adirajyam, the rule of swarga, durmadam, the arrogance that they had in that position, they let go of that arrogance. Apatrapa nashta drishtayaha devaha swayam adipatyat asmadiyat atra bhikshatanam jayaha iti menire. Apatrapa nashta drishtayaha, they lost their sight because of shame. The apatrapa, they were very ashamed of their own behavior, and hence, what was the behavior that they were ashamed of? Nashta drishtayaha. They had lost their sense of sight. In the sense, they did not know which was correct and what they had to pursue. And that is why they lost their position, and that is why Durvasas, they became a party to that curse, right? Because they had lost their drishti. Here, drishti is their outlook, their attitude, because their attitude was not correct. Because of that, they were very ashamed of their position. Tadrishaha devaha swayam adipatyat asmat asmadiyat swakiya swargarajyat swarga samrajyat atra bhikshatanam jayaha iti menire. They thought that in Satyaloka, if I do bhikshatanam, then that is much better. Iti menire. Okay. Atha. Next shlokam. Lakshmi, why don't you read?
Actually, what do you want? Munnadi vandu, just want to make sure.
Which
one? Arambatla. Yoga and the Kevala Manu Adhikaram Adhikara Malakshapanaya Kevala Manuttaram Yoga Ishwarya Manubhavatam.
Okay.
So on that Ava Vanda Upayama Vichinde. அத வந்து ஆனா அல்டிமேட்டா வச்சுக்கல, வெறும் உபாயமா கேவலம் என்னது அந்த க்ஷபனாயக்கு தான், அதிகார மல க்ஷபனாய.
அண்ட் அனுபவதாம்னு இருக்குல்ல, தட் இஸ் யுவர் கீ வேர்ட் தேர். சி, தே டிட் நாட் பர்சியூ இட் இன் ஆர்டர் டு யூனோ, பிகாஸ் தே வாண்டட் தி ஐஸ்வர்யம், அனிமா எல்லாம் வேணுங்கிறதுக்காக தே டிட் நாட் பர்சியூ தி யோகா அண்ட் எவ்ரிதிங். தே வர் டூயிங் இட் சோ தட் தே கேன் get released from this shariram and attain moksha.
அப்போ ஏன் அவர் அந்த அனுத்தரம்னு போடுறாரு? எனக்கு அது புரியல.
அனுத்தரம், that which does not okay, there is no goal beyond this singular. You cannot pursue moksha, you cannot practice moksha, you can only practice yoga, you can only practice samadhi, you cannot practice moksha. So something which is anuttaram na, and the samadhi is equal to, see this is...
So upayeshu anuttaram.
Ah.
Not, idu, enna solradha, attain pandra goal la anuttaram illa.
Illa, illa, illa. So this is the ultimate thing that you can pursue as such, whereas the goal is moksha, and when you are in that moksha state, you don't see any difference between anything. So there is nothing to pursue there.
Okay, okay.
Moksha is equal to you. Avlodhane adu. Anga vandu Brahma jnanam eva moksha. And the ajnana nivritti is equal to moksha. So ajnana nivritti kida you are pursuing all these things. And they have pursued all these things and they have come here to Satyalokam. So they don't need to pursue these things as such. So avadukku adunaladha anubhavathamnu potar. They are enjoying it because no, they like to do this. See, it is like a child, you know, when you are put in the school, you are studying because you have to study. Because you have to pass first standard, you have to pass 10th standard, you have to pass 12th grade, you have to get into college, you have to go to work. Now you are working. Why are you studying again? Because you want to enjoy it.
அப்பதான் என்ஜாய்மெண்ட்
வரும். You never enjoy studying. While you are studying, while you are in school, you never enjoy it at that point of time. You come out of it and then you take up your math book and say, oh, the beautiful concept. That is how it is. While they are doing that yoga, it is only with that moksha in goal. They have attained an adhikara which is beyond that swargalokam. Satyaloka adhikaram is beyond that. Ire, konja naal in the yoga shariratla ire, avadina solrar Shiva. Be in this sharira until, you know, I deem you're done with your work. Until that, just be in the shariram. Whenever I want, you have to go and show your face to this deva so that they can, you know, people know that there is another goal, a superior goal to be achieved beyond this. For that, he has kept these people here. It is not that they are also pursuing this. Beautiful as well. The concept ke evlo alaga adu explain pannirukkar theriyuma.
अथ सुरगुरुम् आगतं सशिष्यं स्वयम् अवधार्य धिया सनत्कुमारः अपगत तमसो महाप्रभावान् अशिष्यमुद्दिश्य सभाजनाय शिष्यान्.
So Sanat Kumara, who is there in that Satyaloka, he understands Swayam Dhiya Avadharya. He understood that Suraguru, that is Brihaspati, had come with his Shishya. Sa Shishyam Indrena Saha or Shishyaihi Saha Agatam Suragurum Brihaspatim Avadharya Manasi Nidhaya or Manasi Nishchitya Dhiya Sanat Kumaraha अपगत तमसः महाप्रभावान् शिष्यान् अमुष्य सभाजनाय अशिषत्. he ordered his shishyas for what? As अमुष्य सभाजनाय अस्य बहुमानकरणाय आतिथ्याय, in order to give atithi satkara for Suraguru, for Brihaspati, he ordered his shishyas. So Amushya is actually Shashti Vyakti for Asau Amu Ami, other Shabda, Pullinga. So Amushya Asya Brihaspatehe Sabhajanaya Pujaya. In order to honor Brihaspati, he sent his Shishyas. Now the two adjectives he puts for his Shishyas are Mahaprabhavana. They are capable of great Prabhava. They have they were capable of performing great tasks. So who had great powers? Mahaprabhavana apagata tamasaha. Because everybody there did not have any tamas. There were only sattva-pradhana people there, right? So apagata tamasaha, those who were devoid of any tamas, their tamas had been removed from their minds. Tatavidana shishyana ashishati adidesha. Okay? So the next paragraph is actually how the Shishyas, as they were going to bring the Brihaspati, they were thinking about the greatness of Brihaspati and they were talking. Read.
Akka, is there any specific rule why we have to use Amushya here and not, Asmin, I mean, Asya?
Instead of Asya? No, there is no rule as such there, because I think there are rules for each and every pronoun that you have to use. Adena idam. Wait.
Vatti cha etado rupam adastu viprakrishtam taditi parokshe vijaniyat.
Tate iti parokshe vijaniyat, that which is not in front of our eyes. Idamastu
sannikrishtam.
Sannikrishtam, which is very close, right? And then
samipataravarti cha etado rupam.
Etadaha rupam. Etat tadoho. Etat rupam mandu. Etat and etat is samipataravarti, that which is even closer. Correct? And amushya is actually distant, remote. Amu amushmin asa asahu is actually viprakrishtam. Viprakrishtam is distant. It is not close by.
Oh, okay. So then why Amushmin Stave? I mean, the Stava is right in front of us, right?
Stava is okay, but Amushmin Stave, I don't know why he says. Here, at least, Amushya Sabhajanaya is very clear, because he says Amushya because Brihaspati is far off. He is outside, right? They just have come to Satyaloka and Sanat Kumara is inside. Hence, he is Viprakrishtam, someone he can see. Because in his eyes, he can see, in his antara, in his mind, he can see Brihaspati. Sanat Kumara can see Brihaspati, right? But Parokshe is who is not in front of our eyes, but it is far off. Oh. Okay, now, Tatu is used for someone whom you don't see in front of your eyes.
Okay.
Asau is used for someone whom you see in front of your eyes, but it is not close by.
Okay.
Now, if, I don't know why Shankaracharya used Amushpin Stave for this.
Adha pannitu ana tena asya shravana tadartha manana dana vardhu.
So,
I am,
you can't very particularly say that he uses only I am and this and that for this. Most of the times, even we use saha agachati. We look at someone who is far off and say saha agachati. We don't use asau agachati all the time.
Oh.
It there are many differences. You can't take it as a strict boundary.
Between idam and etat, so which one is the closest? Like
etat is closest. Samipataravarti etat.
Etat. Idam is just nearby.
Nearby. That's all.
Oh. Okay. Okay.
Idam is nearby. Eshaha. That's why they use even I am as. I am Janaha. That is also Samipam only. Which is closest, I don't know.
Okay.
I am Asau. They talk about one's own body as also I am Asau. I am Aham. I don't know how they... So it's not a strict boundary. You cannot take that sloka as the rule per se. In certain places, it adds beauty to the sloka. Here, for example... whether Sanat Kumara has seen Brihaspati or not, he has understood his arrival, and so he is saying Amushya, but he is still not nearby and he is far off. Hence Amushya Sabhajanaya, that is one thing. The other thing is Prasam. Is because of Anuprasa or alliteration, he uses Ashishad Amushya Sabhajanaya Shishyana. For that Chakara repetition, he uses that Amushya.
Okay. Yeah.
So Atha Suragurum Agatam Sashishyam Swayam Avadharya Dhiya Sanatkumaraha Abhakata Tamaso Mahaprabhavana Ashishad Amushya Sabhajanaya Shishyana. We will stop with this.
So the Kavyam Dradnala Mati Mati interchange panni use panna. Idam.
Naraya Edangalla Kavyatla Vandhu they interchange. There is no strict rule with that. Mostly this Idam Etat Ayam is used for idam and etat is used for closer things, and tat is used for paroksham. This asau is interchangeable. It's got a very
adi perku shabdam theriyadhu, so use panna maata.
And so, nobody knows this rule. Yes, asau is such a difficult shabdam to use. Uses it.
So Akka, one version that I heard from one of my teachers is asau is like you can see it, but it is distant. For example, you can see the stars. So when you see the nakshatram, you have to say asau. You have to use the asau shabda, like anything that is distant, like planets or
Ami nakshatrani.
Yeah, so that is why when I think of Amushmin's Tave, why did he put that? I was thinking, you know, Kamakshi had explained to that that Amushnikam and Iham and that Pratapradyam, she had explained that to me. So I thought maybe that Stavam is like Amushmikam. That is why he used Amushmin.
You can see it, but it is not still not in your mind. That is why you have to constantly keep on reading it.
Oh, super arc, nana arc.
Oh. I don't know. I mean, yeah. If it satisfies you, you can look at it like that. Yeah. Okay.
Thank you so much, Akka.